Mass demonstrations in Madrid turned violent last week. That's after the parliament passed its fifth austerity budget in a row. Police fired rubber bullets to control the angry demonstrators, leaving more than 60 injured. Dozens more were detained. RT's Jacob Greaves has been following developments.
For some time, Greece and Spain have proven the body of anti-austerity protests in the Eurozone. But as time passes, their frustrations and anger only seem to be hardening, lessening the chances of a compromise between politicians and the populace, as many people feel they're only being fed a diet of police batons and broken promises.
Bruised protesters and battered buildings are becoming the Eurozone's currency. From Athens to Madrid, capitals this week have been braced for an onslaught of the angry and indignant.
We want to ask to get out all the politicians on the Congress here.
Austerity measures don't benefit us. They just benefit a very few people on the European Union, on the banks.
These are attitudes of betrayal, first fostered in Greece.
They have promised to renegotiate the famous, the notorious memoranda, that is the agreements between Greece and its lenders. And the state, without any kind of negotiation, they have then promised to Mrs. Merkel and the other European leaders just to implement all the former agreements.
Whilst Athens saw firebombs, a mass Spaniards claimed they were victims of police brutality. Chasing down protesters, they fired rubber bullets into crowds, the injury count from just one night topping 60.
This will last as long as austerity lasts, as neoliberal austerity lasts, and it's going to last as long as it needs to last until people's daily needs are met.
The anti-austerity's rank and file have most recently been bolstered by Portuguese protesters. A nation known for its tolerance of bailout-sponsored cutbacks, reforms that have put the onus of social security payments on workers appear a step too far. But this week's hotspot remains Madrid, where three demonstrations have posed real resistance to the government's public sector cutbacks. Here, the Surround Congress movement has called for the dissolution of Parliament, but their heady claims may do the group more harm than good. Catalonian separatism, with the potential for Spain to lose 20% of its current output, will likely be causing the government yet more sleepless nights. But Prime Minister Rajoy's new budget shows no concessions to anti-austerity protesters, with 40 billion euros of fresh cuts. Economists and activists alike have labelled the move as pandering to EU, Eurozone and IMF demands, adding fuel to the fire, as people populated central Madrid on Saturday to hurl accusations at police and the politicians they shield. Jehu Greaves, RT, Madrid.